and welcome to yet another exciting episode of Action Reaction. As you can see, we have sort of a brand new setup. I hope this is one more step towards improving the quality of the videos. So today, as the title suggests, we are not going to review any figure. So what we are doing is we are going to go ahead, open the figures and make a anti-monitor. Now, this particular wave that I'm going to talk about today belongs to DC Universe Classics, specifically the Wave 17. And I believe this was released somewhere in 2011 when the Blackest Night storyline from DC Universe was on its peak. Now, this particular wave probably had its supporters and its haters, but if you take my humble opinion, I was a fan of the Blackest Night. So when I saw this particular figures, I was excited, and the incentive that it gave me that I'm going to have my own anti-monitor, that was more than sufficient. So the reason that I'm not going to review this figure is very simple. This figure were made like 10 years ago, so there is no point in reviewing this figure. At this point, the availability of this figure is only secondary market, so there is no real point in doing that. But let's go ahead and play with our nostalgia factor, right? So this particular wave consists of 6 figures, 7 to be specific, if you understand that there is a variant that comes into the figure. So we have the very first figure that belongs to the Sinestro Corps, specifically Scarecrow. Here is the figure. Here's the small bio for Scarecrow. This looks pretty good, you know, considering this is a 10-year-old figure, but at least look-wise, this looks very nice. And this figure also comes with the right leg for anti-monitor. If you can see, that's the anti-monitor, and that's what we are gonna make. So figure number one, Sinestro Corps Scarecrow. We move to figure number two. That's where we dwell into the land of compassion. That is the realm of Indigo Lanterns. And nobody is more compassionate than the Atom Ray Palmer. So if you can see his figure. And what Ray Palmer or the Atom comes with is the right arm of the anti-monitor. The third figure belongs to one of the biggest masterminds of DC Universe. Often villain, often hero. I would say he belongs to sort of the gray area of an anti-hero. That's Lex Luthor, specifically the Orange Lantern version of Lex Luthor, whose main powers, the Orange Lanterns, the main power of Orange Lantern is the power of greed, appearance, right? So everything they need, everything belongs to them, and they are thirsty, they are hungry for everything. So this is the Orange Lantern version of Lex Luthor. And what this figure comes with is the left leg for anti-monitor. The next figure belongs to Barry Allen, or as we know him, the Flash. This is specifically the Blue Lantern version of the Flash, who represents hope. Hope is something without which, you know, there is simply no life. So he represents one of the important aspects of life, that's hope. With this figure, what we have is the left arm for the anti-monitor. The next figure that we have, this is the fifth in the line, that is the Green Lantern Hal Jordan, specifically the Black Lantern Hal Jordan. Now, this is the avatar of Black Lanterns, who represent the death aspect in DC Universe. So they were sort of the antagonist in the Blackest Night storyline. So this is a very good representation of that Black Lantern. And this is the figure that comes with a variant. So we have a Black Lantern Hal Jordan. We also have a White Lantern Hal Jordan. See, if you can see it over here. So this guy comes with the head and the lower torso of anti-monitor. The final figure in the wave belongs to none other than our Wonder Woman, Diana. Now, Diana always represents the power of love in our DC Universe. There is no other representation of the Star Sapphire or the Violet Lanterns other than Diana. So here we have, that's Diana. And what we get with this figure is the upper and the middle torso for the anti-monitor. So great. A total of 6 figures is going to make our anti-monitor. So let's go ahead and open them. We'll be right back. the White Lantern variant of Hal Jordan. So this is the entire ensemble of the Wave 70. Now, six figures make this into, Anti-Monitor. The only problem that I have is there is no Red Lantern or Green Lantern in this wave. Now, let's see. We have an Orange Lantern, we have a Violet Lantern, we have a Blue Lantern, we have an Indigo Lantern, we have a Yellow Lantern. So we are missing, effectively, a Green Lantern and a Red Lantern, right? So, I mean, I'm cool with the idea of a Black Lantern Hal Jordan and a White Lantern Hal Jordan, but for Blackest Night to go ahead, I would have been more happy if, instead of these two figures, I mean, one of the variants would have been a Green Lantern. And also, if they would have probably leader of Red Lantern, Atrocious, I think that's what his name is, I would have been much more happier. But, I mean, this is how the cards are dealt, and this is what we have. So, not a problem. Now, before we go ahead and build the Anti-Monitor, let's just take a minute and look at this figure. I'll start with the Lex Luthor. So, what we see is a very translucent type armor for Lex Luthor. Again, the figure nails it, the headpiece nails it. That's the only thing of Lex Luthor that we see. Overall, I'll say this is nice. I believe this is sort of a bit rocky. I don't know why. But I think that's cool. If you see over here, that's the symbol of Orange Lantern. And we have Orange Lantern with him. There is no holder to hold this particular guy, but I understand. Orange Lantern means greed. So I'm assuming that he's always going to hold his lantern very close to him. So, you know, I get that point. So that was Lex Luthor. Next, we have Sinestro Corps. We have Scarecrow. And this is exactly how I remember Scarecrow being in the Blackest Night comic book. You know, he had his hat, his Scarecrow mask. If you can see, that's the emblem or the symbol for Sinestro Corps. He had a trench coat on him and, you know, this beautiful gauntlets. And also, if you can see, the Sinestro Corps ring. And, you know, a very detailed, specifically, you know, if you see that Hangman, that neck noose, that noose from his neck, you know, that's pretty well. And I also love this hat. This is like best of both worlds, the Sinestro Corp and the Scarecrow. I did not have a Scarecrow figure, so, you know, this is a good addition. And if we take a look at the lantern, yeah, this is beautiful. This is nice. And let's go ahead and review our Indigo Lantern, that's Atom, so Ray Palmer. So, Indigo Lanterns, they do not have any lantern per se. This guy comes with a stick, as you can see. And I believe this somehow channels the emotions of compassion through a Indigo Lantern. I think they have nailed the Atom figure to the dot. I mean, it is the most beautiful figure in this particular wave that I have seen. If you can see, yeah. So, this is not like your normal costume. So, Indigo Lanterns are supposed to be sort of nomadic tribe, and that's what this figure represents. If you see, you know, they have nailed it very well. That's the symbol for Indigo Lantern. That's the symbol for Atom. Yep. Then we have this gauntlets. That's nice. Then some tattoos which represent the Indigo Lantern. They are done pretty well. I do not know what this is, but probably some ornament or some small sachet. A very fantastic set of boots. So I'm really happy. I mean, if I was rating all these figures, this would have been at the top. I would have given it, you know, a perfect 10. Justice Man, that's the Flash. And this is more or less the costume of Flash, you know, palette swap for blue and black instead of red and yellow. But he represents the Blue Lantern of Hope. And it is said that there is nobody bigger of a hoper or hopeful than Barry Allen. I used to assume Superman was, the character who embodied hope the best, but turns out it is Barry Allen. So I'm okay with that. And again, if you see the blue ring of hope, that's his ring. And they have kept all the essentials of a Flash costume that I can see. Again, those lightning bolts, you know, you have the Flash symbol, and underneath that Flash symbol you have the symbol of Blue Lantern. So I'll say it's a nice figure. Yeah. And this is the Blue Lantern, of course, pretty nice. And they have given it, so all the lanterns, I think they have some metallic touch which enhances their, you know, quality of it. Now we have two Hal Jordans. I'm going to review them together. So this is the Black Lantern Hal Jordan. So black is the color, or Black Lantern represent the death. or the stillness in the universe. So they were again the main antagonist of the Blackest Night storyline. So if you can see the symbol with a triangle and I believe six lines on the top of it, that's who the Black Lanterns were. And if you can see, so they are sort of like all the dead characters, be it heroes or villains who had died in the history, in the DC universe, had come back to life. They were reanimated by Black Hand on the orders of Necron. Now Necron is another sort of a cosmic level big baddie in the DC universe. So that's why you can see he has more of a pale looking face. He's sort of growling. I wouldn't say call them as zombie because they were still intelligent. You know, they retained all the memories from their previous life. So this is like a normal Green Lantern costume. You can see the Green Lantern symbol under which we have the Black Lantern symbol. So this is pretty much a Green Lantern costume palette swap for black and gray instead of green and black. So again, good. And this is the variant for Hal Jordan. This is the White Lantern version. Again, the same costume, just green and black palette swap for white and silverish. There is just one problem that I see with this. So white color represents life. But if you see the expression on this Hal Jordan, I am not, you know, this is not a very lifelike feeling. This is just like a less severe reaction than this. So I was hoping a bit better, since this was a variant, I was hoping it would be, you know, a bit better in terms of the emotions. We are talking about Blackest Night. We are talking about emotional spectrum, right? I was hoping a better emotion on his face. And again, we have a white ring. And again, White Lantern, there is only one White Lantern at a time. And at that time, it was Hal Jordan. So, Black Lantern, White Lantern, they were the embodiment of death and life in the DC universe. So, a Black Lantern was very difficult to, you know, destroy. There were only two ways that these Black Lanterns could be destroyed. Either through the combined power of all these seven Lanterns in any combination, but more than one or two, I think. That could destroy them, or if a White Lantern could just bring them back to life, or probably negate their effect. So that was the essence. So the end of Blackest Night resulted into the birth of the first White Lantern, and that was the start of the Brightest Day. Of course, Brightest Day was not as good as Blackest Night, but I mean, I still like it. And finally, we have the Sapphire Lantern or Star Sapphire or the Purple Lanterns. That is our own Diana Prince, the Wonder Woman. Nobody loves in DC Universe more than Wonder Woman. She cares for every living organism that we can find. So she was the best embodiment for being a Star Sapphire. And as you can see, that's the metallic lantern for Star Sapphire. And this is sort of a bit different from the other lanterns. I actually like this a bit more. It's more curvy. Yeah, but again, they have retained more or less the costume of Wonder Woman. You also see the Lasso of Truth and specifically the ring for Star Sapphires. Yeah, so nice figure. So that roundabouts the figures that were needed to create the Anti-Monitor. Now let's go ahead and create the Anti-Monitor itself. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different individual parts for Anti-Monitor. Now, if you have already read Blackest Night, you would know why Anti-Monitor is, you know, the part of Build-A-Figure game. For those who are not aware of the Blackest Night storyline, let me tell you. At the end of Sinestro Corps War, I have all the relevant links out in the description, but at the end of Sinestro Corps War, Anti-Monitor was one of the guardians for Sinestro Corps. And at the end of that particular war, Superman Prime threw his husk, his defeated husk, through the cosmos, and he landed on a planet called Rhea. That's in Sector 666 in the Green Lantern mythologies, right? So Anti-Monitor was chosen to be the power source for the Black Lantern, the only Black Lantern that's available. So at the end of the day, to defeat the threat of Black Lanterns, this Anti-Monitor had to be brought back to life, and that removed, effectively, that negated some of the powers of Necron, right? Or the Black Lantern Corps. So I think he was one of the catalysts that led to the downfall of the Black Lantern. So without wasting any time, let's go ahead and put this figure. So what we have is the upper torso, and he comes with a cape. And I don't really like this material for the cape. It's needed to be much more better. I mean, this is just like a rag is what I feel. They should have put in a good cloth, or probably it's a 10-year-old figure. Probably it has lost its shine. I don't know, but it needed something better. No, not this cloth. But okay, other than that, if you look at the torso, it's soft plastic, which is good. And it is sort of painted in metallic, which is always a plus. So let's go ahead. This is the head for Anti-Monitor. As you can see, he's a being of pure antimatter energy, right? So he doesn't really have a body. His body is made up of antimatter. So let's go ahead, put his head and hope that it sticks, or probably there could be another way. That let's remove this. Let's put, and then we just, yeah, looks nice. Now I just hope that this figure towers over all of them. It probably will, but no, let's hope. Now this is his left hand. Let's go ahead, put it down in the socket. There it is. That's his left hand. Let's go ahead and lock his right hand. There it is. Now let's hold his armor. So we have assembled his top body, and right now, yes, I do see that he will tower over all of them. Let's have his mid torso connected. I think these figures have some locking mechanism, which is good. There it goes. Now legs, let's put the left, I hope that this is the left leg. Oh yeah, and the right leg. Oh man. So that's our Anti-Monitor. Wow, he looks amazing. I mean, they have captured the Crisis of Earth Anti-Monitor very nicely. So if you have seen my older reviews, I already have a dark side. This guy will not be as tall as him, but finally I can have a dark side versus Anti-Monitor. That this is cool. This is cool. And let's quickly just see his articulations. Of course, the head goes left and right. Yeah, it wouldn't go up and down. His hand, it goes this much up. I don't think so. It is going to turn around that efficiently, but it does turn around. If you can see, yeah. There is a this wires might create some problem, so the bicep curl would not be efficient on this one because they are connected. Let's have his arm. It goes 90 degrees. Then I don't effectively think you can probably swing his hand a bit, but not really a lot of things that you can do. Then he has a waist. He has a chest articulation, which so. This much forward, this much back. Then he can effectively turn completely around, which is nice. When it comes to leg, yeah, this is how much it goes forward. This is how much it goes back. He cannot, yeah, and this is how much it goes side. So effectively this guy can do a split. Perfect. Can he stand? That's a different question. But he does a split. So that is really nice. And then I don't see any thigh articulation. Oh, there is a thigh articulation. Yeah, this is a very old figure, so this joints might probably be a bit. And oh my goodness, I think I have broken this. Oh shoot, oh shoot, oh shoot. Oh man, that's the wear and tear. That's is the thing that I'm afraid of the most. And I have effectively broken this guy. Yeah. I should not really do these things, but no worries. I mean, we can effectively go ahead and fix them. Oh, you know what? This just went in. Yeah. So we have a damaged Anti-Monitor, and that is cool because I'm not going to sell him. He'll always be in my collection. Yeah. This is how much it goes back down. This is nice. Yeah. So it effectively goes 90 degrees. I have to actually go ahead and stick this thing with. Yeah. So this is brittle. This is very brittle. Be careful. Okay. And then leg. No, it's, I think this is a very old figure, so I do understand its part might be a bit, you know, weathered out because of the time that has passed. So this was our Anti-Monitor, and I finally managed to break it out, literally and figuratively. And he just towers over all of them.
So with that, I will end this unboxing slash review video for the Anti-Monitor Wave. I really had fun exploring this old action figures and remembering one of my favorite storylines of all the time, the Blackest Night. Please do like and share this video. Please do subscribe to my channel for more awesome content. And thank you for sticking with me and I will see you in my next video. Thank you, and please do take very good care of yourselves. Bye.